Welcome and thank you for your interest in our data published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. My name is Ali Abbara from Imperial College London and I'll be presenting an author's take on our work investigating the potential of the novel Kisspeptin receptor agonist MVT602 for the treatment of reproductive disorders in women. The importance of Kisspeptin in the control of the reproductive endocrine axis became apparent in 2003 with the publication of these two seminal papers, which showed that Kisspeptin signalling was absolutely essential for reproductive health. Since then, it's now established that Kisspeptin acts on GnRH neurons in the hypothalamus to in turn stimulate the remainder of the reproductive axis. Now, there are a number of forms of Kisspeptin of different peptide lengths, where the number of amino acids is indicated by their suffix. So, for example, Kisspeptin 54 contains 54 amino acids. All the Kisspeptins share a decapeptide sequence that is equivalent to Kisspeptin 10, which is important for activation of the Kisspeptin receptor. In the present study, we investigate a novel Kisspeptin receptor agonist called MVT602, which was developed based on modifications to Kisspeptin 10 to increase potency, stability, and water solubility. Whilst Kisspeptin has a number of potential indications for the treatment of female reproductive disorders, to date there is no data describing the profile of MVT602 in women. Therefore, Professor Waljit Dillo's group at Imperial College London conducted clinical studies to delineate for the first time the endocrine profile of MVT602 in women. 9 healthy women received a single subcutaneous injection of MVT602 or the native Kisspeptin compound, Kisspeptin 54, in the early follicular phase, followed by an extended duration of detailed endocrine sampling. And we found that MVT602 induced a prolonged rise in serum LH, but to a similar amplitude as Kisspeptin 54, consistent with their common mode of action via the Kisspeptin receptor on hypothalamic GnRH neurons. This prolonged LH profile could have been attributed to a difference in pharmacokinetic properties between MVT602 and native Kisspeptin 54. However, in fact, pharmacokinetic parameters were similar. Therefore, to investigate this further, Dr. Aileen Hanyuloglu at Imperial College London compared the action of MVT602 and Kisspeptin 54 on intracellular signalling in HEC293 cells transfected with the G-protein-coupled Kisspeptin receptor. Her group showed that MVT602 was more potent than Kisspeptin 54 with regards to IP1 levels, and that calcium signalling was similar on continuous incubation with these ligands. Professor Sue Monta's group at the University of Michigan built on this finding by conducting electrophysiological studies on murine GnRH neurons to show that MVT602 induced a longer duration of action potential firing compared to native Kisspeptin 54. And this finding is particularly edifying given the endocrine profiles observed from the clinical studies in women. Next, we investigated whether the endocrine profile of MVT602 differed in women with either of the two commonest causes of anovulation, namely polycystic ovary syndrome and hypothalamic amenorrhea. Whilst the LH rise was similar in women with PCOS as in healthy women, LH rises were markedly increased and expedited in women with hypothalamic amenorrhea, with a much earlier peak than other women. And this was also true of the FSH rise, which has significant implications for the potential use of MVT602 as an ovulation induction agent in women with hypothalamic amenorrhea. So finally, on behalf of all of the authors, we thank you for your interest in our work, and we're optimistic that we can translate our findings on the Kisspeptin receptor agonist MVT602 to benefit women with reproductive disorders in the near future. Thank you.